Google AI is putting some companies out of business. Google AI decimates news traffic. With AI serving up click-free answers, search traffic to HuffPost and The Washington Post has declined by over half in the last 3 years. The Atlantic expects its own will eventually reach zero. To combat the changes and forge alternate connections with its readers, publishers are turning to newsletters, apps, and live events. This is wild, but not really that surprising, because if you go to regular Google search and you put in something like business news, you'll see that the Wall Street Journal, the New York Times, Bloomberg, WSJ, you see all of them up here. But what happens when people are going to places like ChatGPT to get their sources? They don't have to go through a million options where the first 5 to 7 are sponsored anyway. So LinkedIn has something where you could offer your perspective. I'm going to go through some of the top perspectives. Publications, including the WSJ, are responding to upheaval in search and the growth of AI chatbots by trying to forge more direct relationships with readers and offering distinctive journalism based on deep reporting and scoops that an AI bot can't pull from the web on its own. Who do you think will manage to stand out and pivot successfully enough to retain readers in an AI-driven future? What, if anything, would make you want to go to a particular news site to read a story, watch a video, listen to an interview, rather than just ask ChatGPT for the summary? Google's new AI answers slash news clicks in half. That's the headline. But here's the punchline. It won't stop at news. And that's true. So this is Amazon eating retail all over again. One algorithm owns discovery. Everyone else disappears. This also presents a huge danger, which is why people like Gary Vee are constantly saying to build your personal brand and to have that awareness. And he uses Pizza Hut as an example, but the same example applies to your expertise. You don't want someone to go to Google AI mode or ChatGPT or wherever, Claude Manus, and say, what is the best pizza in my town? Or who is the best consultant that I can go to for XYZ? You want them to say, what's the number for the closest Pizza Hut? Or what courses does Shanae Murray have available? You want them to already be aware of you before going to their chatbot. And that's really only done through brand and through brand awareness, which is why he's screaming at everyone to start leveraging social media and to be posting on all the major platforms every single day. Because if you own that brand awareness, then let's say you pop up as a top search result for Google today, even in AI mode, who says that tomorrow they don't start charging you to pop up in that space? We just don't know what's to come. So my prediction is OpenAI starts buying newsrooms. They need proprietary data. Publishers need buyers. But here's what every brand is missing. When ChatGPT answers questions about your company, that becomes your reality. The media apocalypse is here, and your brand strategy just became an AI strategy. It should have become an AI strategy a year ago, but if you're here today, you're probably a year ahead of most of your competitors. And yes, it's time for the shift. But it also presents a huge opportunity, like I said, because if you're competing against some of the biggest news sources or companies in your niche, and you don't have the same spending power, then you'll always be towards the bottom after all the sponsored section on Google search. Now you could be the first, the second, the third, if you at least know how to play your cards right, and if you start to create high quality content. SEO just got a whole lot bigger. It's no longer just about ranking on Google. It's not about keywords and backlinks alone. It's not even about traffic. Welcome to the era of search everywhere optimization. Your buyers, they're not just Googling anymore. Most of them are probably not Googling. They're scrolling LinkedIn, searching TikTok, asking ChatGPT, checking Reddit, voice commanding Siri. They're also going to YouTube, getting recommendations inside Facebook groups. That's interesting. I would have definitely replaced this one with getting recommended videos inside of YouTube over Facebook groups, but okay. This isn't a trend, it's a tectonic shift in behavior. I think the shift has been happening. I just think that this is a thing now because some of the biggest companies are starting to feel the negative effects monetarily of this shift happening. The modern buyer is search savvy, but not search engine dependent. So if your strategy only revolves around Google rankings, you're invisible in 80% of the places people are actively seeking answers. You're not just competing for traffic, you're competing for visibility in an ecosystem where answers are generated, not just linked. The brands that understand this and show up across search experiences are the ones becoming category leaders. If you're still playing the old SEO game, it's time to rethink. 100%. This was also compounded, by the way, Gary Vee uploaded a video, and I think one of the first things that he said in the video was that Google search is dead. I like change. Things are shifting. It presents a new challenge and a new opportunity. So I'm going to show you what Google AI mode looks like. This is important for you to know because you need to put yourself in your potential customer's shoes, your future prospect, your dream client. If they do search for something, you need to see what that looks like for them versus what it used to look like, because AI mode is going to be rolling out. And I'd say probably by the end of the year, they're going to have a lot more users just getting used to AI mode compared to traditional Google search. Google AI mode. AI mode is our most powerful AI search. Ask whatever's on your mind to get an AI-powered response and explore further with follow-up questions and helpful web links. Basically, this is their response to ChatGPT taking a lot of their search engine traffic. Now, to sign up for this, you'll go to search.google. So search.google, and you should see this page. When you scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see sign up. Once you do, welcome to Search Labs. Here you'll see new experiments and it'll say AI mode. You're going to click AI mode and then click join to try. It's going to look something like this. Here's where you would query. So instead of seeing all the stuff that we see on Google's regular page, you would just search here. Once you put in a search, you're going to see an answer here. There's going to be some description, but the main thing to look at is that there are only 12 results that pop up. Only 3 of those 12 show at the top. Most people probably won't even see the show all. They probably won't even click on it. So the first thing that I recommend that you do is to start playing around with some of the searches and start seeing if you rank for anything. This will obviously require you understanding what people are searching. And if I were you as a business owner, I would just double down on the things that, you know, your top clients, the top 20%. What are the questions that they ask you? What are the reasons that they choose you? What are the patterns? And you should be paying enough attention to this to really understand why it is that they come to you over somebody else. For me, one of those things is live video on LinkedIn. If I put LinkedIn live video for entrepreneurs in AI mode, you see that I'm ranking pretty well here. Now, I want you to notice something. I want you to notice the way that I ranked 2 of the top 3 places here has nothing to do with a blog on my website, but it does have to do with LinkedIn. The reason is because when LinkedIn originally launched collaborative articles, which were AI-generated articles that people would give answers to, what they did is they literally started to create thousands and thousands of user-generated articles a day, like blog posts, mini blog posts a day. And when you look at the chart of their domain authority, when they did that, their domain authority skyrocketed. So when you start your LinkedIn newsletter, when you publish weekly and you do it strategically, you can start to rank pretty fast on things like this because you're riding an SEO unicorn. Let's look at LinkedIn live video tips. Live video tips for business. So I'm just going to start searching. I would probably start maybe with 20 searches and see if you rank anywhere. I'm actually surprised that I do with this one. I didn't think that I was going to, but I'm number 3. What I could start to do is look at, okay, why is this number 2? Why is this number 1? I could click on them. I could see if they're more thorough. I could see what gaps are missing in that information. From what you see here, 2 out of the 3 results, if you just keep paying attention, a lot of them are LinkedIn. Manus AI website. I could see if I rank here, right here. the two sources leveraged in a lot of these answers are YouTube videos, because they're usually very thorough, in-depth, have great information. The actual company website, so this is actually coming from Manus. And then LinkedIn newsletters are still 2 out of the 12 that are mentioned, which doesn't seem like a lot, but when there's only real estate for 12 spots, it's a lot. So another thing to bring to your attention is just the duo, the power of leveraging both YouTube and LinkedIn together. Because for me, you just multiply your chances of being able to take one of those top 3 spots at the top, or one of the 1 of 12 spots, because this is really huge. We went from a page that had a bunch of stuff on it, where the top people were paid ads, to a page where now there's only 12 options at most. I'll share the process that I am doing. By no means am I an SEO expert, but I think that I understand that some of the best content just rises to the top, and I understand some of the things that my people search for. So number 1 is paying attention to your audience. I think if you know what your audience is searching for, even if you can anticipate some of those needs, like I'm going to tell you, one thing that my audience searches for is like how to set up your live video on StreamYard. I should be doing that. Or I should also be doing what's the best live software for LinkedIn. Those are the things that I'm going to be pumping out because I want to take some of that real estate. So it's knowing your audience, number 1. Number 2, it's testing to see where you are. Even if you rank on 0 of the results, just understand that if you were to launch your LinkedIn newsletter, publish weekly, and start to share great information, that you don't have to depend on just your blog or your website. You're depending on the SEO power of LinkedIn. And I understand that the LinkedIn newsletter name is misleading because it's basically like a blog. You don't get the emails. You do get the list of people that subscribe, but leverage it at least to bring traffic to maybe your website that you link within the newsletter. I'm going to be talking about all of this. I'm hosting 5 private live trainings for free. So you could go to yougrow.club. Once you know what your people are searching, then you can operationally organize yourself to start to create some of these videos. If you're a perfectionist, one of the easier things to do is actually go live. It'll force yourself to do it. And when you're live, you may have different personality, like in terms of more energy, because there's pressure. People are watching. It's scary, but it'll at least force you to complete it versus you recording it. You're a perfectionist. You'll never get it done. At least go live. And of course, between those 2 points, you want to actually outline some very helpful information. Once you go live, what you could do is then upload that live video of your LinkedIn Live to YouTube, edit it a little bit. And then from there, you can use tools like ChatGPT to get the transcript and then publish the newsletter and embed your YouTube video within that newsletter. You can do this even without a marketing team. You can do this even if you're bad at tech. In fact, if you're not the best at tech, you're actually probably in the best lane and the highest chance of success lane for yourself, because you don't really have to worry about fancy video editing. The main thing here is just be aware. It's an opportunity. Start to test. Start to look at where you're not ranking. Start to look at what is ranking at the top and just create a better video, a better resource, a better blog than that thing at the top and see what happens. And it doesn't have to take a long time. The Manus example that I showed you on AI mode, that's less than a month. I did another one with Manus slides. I did a Manus slides presentation on YouTube a couple of weeks ago. That one was already ranking 2. So because of LinkedIn's power with the domain authority, you could probably publish a newsletter this week that could rank at least within the top 12. Put yourself in the shoes of the person that you want to attract and do what is most helpful for them. From them knowing what to click on, the title, from them seeing the most helpful resource out there and being able to get a result because of it. You want people to be able to actually benefit from your free content, and then they'll keep looking for more. And if you really want to dive deep, it's going to be 5 hours of free live training next week, 1 hour a day for 5 days in a row, explaining this whole system and process and playbook. Then go to yougrow.club and register. It's going to be awesome. It's taken me tens and tens of hours to put together, but I want to help you. Ciao.